In the third point of our lecture, and that is, how do we remain firm in the times of fitna? The second point before we move on to the third point is, what is the dangers of fitna? The dangers of fitna are many, especially if we know that the first problem of fitna is that it takes away our heart. And the heart is the basis of our intellect and our desires and our faculties. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in an authentic hadith in the Sahihain, he said that indeed there is in the body a piece of flesh. If it is good, if it is perfect, then the whole body will be perfect. And if it is evil, then the whole body itself will be evil. Indeed, this piece of flesh is the heart. So the fitnas, they go and they are passed upon the qalb, the heart. And the heart, if it is affected by these fitnas, it will affect the whole body. The Prophet ﷺ said, indeed, there is in the heart, there is in the body a piece of flesh. When it is perfect, the whole body will be perfect. When it is pure, the body will be pure. When it is evil, the whole body will be evil. Abu Huraira said that the heart is the king of all of the other limbs. So if the king is good, then all of the people underneath him will be good. And if the king is evil, then all of the people beneath him will be evil too. Many of the youth ask, I can't memorize the Quran, and I can't memorize the Sunnah, and I can't memorize the religious knowledge that is given in khutbas. I can't stop looking at dirty pictures and evil movies, and so many other complaints. We say you won't be able to do anything until you protect your heart, until you start giving medicine to the king itself of your body. Then all of the other limbs will follow the king. When you cure the king, then all of the other limbs are going to follow. A man came to Sufyan al-Thawri and he said, O Sufyan, my heart has become sick and I have become far away from Allah. And so the Shaykh says, if one of us has a physical ailment of our heart, then he's going to spend every single dollar he has, every single doctor, he's going to go to every specialist to cure himself. Every single cure that he can find, every single process. But he doesn't think about the spiritual part of the heart. To go to the ulama and get the spiritual part cured, so that he can cure the spiritual disease that he has in his heart. To go to the real specialist of the heart, not the doctor, but the alim. So he's giving the example of the man that he came to Sufyan al-Thawri and complained about his heart, whereas we go to the doctors. So he said, O Sufyan, my heart has become sick. What was the sickness? That my heart is far away from Allah. So what is the solution? Sufyan said, go to sincerity, the depths of sincerity, and the patience, and humility. Put all of this in the a utensil of taqwa, and pour upon it the fear of Allah. And then light it with your own fuels. Think of your fuels. And then take it with a sincere potion. Put it in the utensil of istighfar. When you do all of this, then you will be cured from your disease of the heart, inshaAllah. You will never be able to save in this life except with your pure heart. Allah says on the day that no money and children will benefit you except the one who came with a pure heart. What is the pure heart? Ibn Qayyim said, the heart will never be pure until it is pure of five things. Until it is pure of shirk that goes against tawheed. And when it is pure of innovation, and it is pure of being away from Allah, and it is pure of following His desires. And it is pure of trying to show off your deeds for the sake of Allah. And all of these conditions are necessary of its own lecture. The day that money and children will not benefit except he who comes with a pure heart. The problem of fitna is that it is settled down in the heart. A man looks at a beautiful woman or a naked picture. Then he turns away. And he closes the TV or he closes the magazine. And he goes back to his house. Then when he sits down on his desk, he remembers the picture that he saw. Is this not true? If he sits down on his bed, he sees the woman in front of him. Even though she is not, but he thinks of her. And he remembers the picture that he saw. Why? Even though the picture has gone away, but the picture has been imprinted in the heart. The picture has been photocopied onto the heart. Look at what the Prophet ﷺ said in an authentic hadith reported by Muslim from Hudayfa ibn al-Yaman radiallahu anhu. He said that the fitnas are presented upon the heart. Careful, the fitnas are not only taken upon the eyes and the ears, no. Look at what the Prophet is saying, the fitnas are presented to the heart. Many people think that they will only see the fitna with their eyes or with their ears and then that's it. But no, the Prophet said the fitnas go upon the qalb, the heart. Just like a branch is stripped away part by part. A tree is stripped away branch by branch. So you see, for example, a large tree. But if you keep on taking away oud, I mean branch by branch, this is how the heart will be taken away by every fitna, branch by branch. So whatever heart has been taken up by the fitna, there is a black spot put on the heart. And any heart that rejects the fitna has a white spot on him. So then the hearts become one of two categories. Either a heart that is pure black, it doesn't know good and it doesn't reject evil. Only it follows its desires. The other opposite is the pure white heart. Not a single fitna will be able to afflict it as long as the heavens and earth exist. Pure white heart. The qalb or the heart is where the fitnas are presented. If the heart takes the fitna, then the black spot is formed. If the heart drinks up the fitna, so then if the heart drinks up the fitna, then it will want another one. It will want another one. He will then go a third and a fourth. He will look at another picture. Until the heart becomes rusted, like the Prophet, like Allah says, indeed their hearts have become spoiled with rust because of what they do. Indeed, on that day they will be prevented from seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. When the fitna goes into the heart, there is a dark spot put on it. But if the person goes and seeks Allah's forgiveness, then that black spot is removed. The Prophet said, whenever a person does a sin, his heart will become black. But if he repents and stops and seeks his forgiveness, then his black spot will be taken away. But if he returns, then the black spot will return. Until the heart will become rusted. And this is what Allah says in the Quran, that indeed their hearts will be rusted because of what they have done. So the fitnas, oh my brothers, are presented to the hearts. If the heart drinks up the fitna, then the heart will be destroyed. Khalas, the person will be destroyed. Some might well say, the sunnah time has gone, we're now in the time of the internet and the jet plane. Wine is haram, the Shaykh is saying, it doesn't change. But the khamr that the Prophet, that was prohibited in the Prophet's time, is different. In our times we call it spirits and refined wines. It's not the haram, it's not the prohibited thing. So you tell him pork is haram, he'll say, yes, I'm not saying pork is haram, but the pork that was prohibited was a sick, dirty pig. As for our pork, it is purified and clear.